The following is a true horror story about a school bus kidnapping. On July 15, 1976, three men kidnapped 26 school kids from a school bus in California. The children in the bus were ages 5 to 14. They held shotguns to the kids, dressed like bank robbers with pantyhose over their faces. They poked the kids in the belly, telling them to shut up. One said, "Tell me your name or you're never gonna see your mommy and daddy again." They drove the kids around for 2 hours in two vans, then forced everyone to climb into a hole in the ground, into a box truck which was buried underground in a rock quarry. They then sealed the hole, leaving the kids and the bus driver buried alive. It felt to the kids in there like a grave. While they left cereal, peanut butter, and bread, it ran out quickly, and there was no ventilation. During this terrifying experience, the driver emerged as the hero, comforting the kids. They were in there for 16 hours before they escaped by digging through 3 feet of dirt. The kidnappers were caught and sentenced to life in prison. This is what one of the kidnappers said was the reason he picked to kidnap children.
"We picked children because they are precious. The state would be willing to pay for them, and they don't fight back. They're vulnerable. They will do what we tell them to."
The kidnapper also said what made them put everyone inside the box truck underground.
"The first place I picked was a barn. Mr. Woods, one of the kidnappers, had 7 acres in Fremont that had a barn on it. But the barn was old and full of holes. You'd need 4 people on each side to keep everybody from escaping. So I thought, how about a moving van? And I just wanted something that everyone would fit into and they couldn't get out of. We thought that in a moving van, they could just cut through the sheet metal walls and get out. Then the idea came to bury the van. If it was underground, they couldn't just cut through the walls and get out."
So these bad guys are all in prison now, right? No. Life in prison doesn't mean life in prison in America. You would think they'd be locked away forever. But you get the chance for parole, which allows you to go free and be let out of prison. In this case, which was in Chowchilla, California, the former sheriff, prosecutor, and judge in the case said the kidnapper's sentence was too much, and on June 20th, 2012, the first of the kidnappers, Richard Schoenfield, was set free. What happened to the kids? They grew into adults, and a lot were depressed. Some felt that bad things would happen to them. The trauma of the kidnappings caused them a lot of problems. Some couldn't stop dreaming about killing the kidnappers. Others couldn't sleep, even with the nightlight on, or ride in a subway, or go underground. Whenever anyone commits a crime, there are consequences for the victims. You might think a simple burglary is harmless, but it isn't. It terrifies those who are victims to it. We can only imagine what these kids went through. What was the reason for the kidnappings? It was all for money. The kidnappers had planned to demand $5 million for their release. When the school bus went missing, so many distraught and worried families started calling the police that the phone lines got so busy that the kidnappers hadn't actually been able to call in their ransom demand. By 2015, the second of the kidnappers was set free. The third kidnapper is eligible for parole this year. So, all three will be out. If you ever think you're safe from bad guys, don't. They can go anywhere, be anywhere. All it takes is getting into a car, and they could come near you. It's always good to watch out and keep vigilant, but sometimes there's just nothing you can do.